This is more or less my favorite lecture. I will always start here, and as you all know, water is always flowing from left to right. That's very important. And if someone present a drawing with the opposite, it's very difficult to... it is. And I will come back to this. I just have to spend... Here is some mountains. And we have a downstream area. Intake here. An intake gate. Maybe like this is a tunnel system. I will come back to this, so this is just my drawing. I will add one secondary intake here. Back in talk. And we will have a surge chamber, maybe like this. A pressure shaft. This is useless, unfortunately. We will have a powerhouse here with a generator. I'm coming back to everything. A turbine, just by principle. I know, Ole Gunnar, you are disappointed about my drawing about the turbine. There will be an inlet valve here, a pipe, draft tube. And a tunnel system ending up about here. This hydropower plant utilizes the difference in... Now I recognize that this must be extended like this. There is a difference in head, which is given by H. And this is the potential for the hydropower plant. There is a water stored here, which can be dropped down, and we can utilize this head. And this head can be utilized by for power production. And this equation gives the production in kilowatt. So there is an efficiency rate, a discharge, which is cubic meter per second, the gravity, and the H. This is the principle for a hydropower plant. And this tunnel system and this conduit here transport the water from here, and it even distribute the pressure from here down to the turbine. And now I like to give you an overview of all the elements here, which is influential for the operation of the hydropower plant. And that may happen. Yes. This is the dam. And the dam is normally there to develop a reservoir. It's simple like that. But in addition, this dam also lift the water level, which also will influence this age. Because if you just had the intake, of course, this would be the potential height. But this dam here lift the head, increase the head for the power plant, and it creates a reservoir. And normally, and I like to use the Norwegian words here, because this will also be a basic course in Norwegian hydropower language, for those of you who don't are familiar with this. This reservoir and this dam is designed to lift the water level to the highest regulated water level, HRV. And this is also designed to a minimum LRV level. And in all licenses for hydropower plants in Norway, those two limitations, they are given by a meter above sea level. So this is given by the license, HRV and LRV. And this dam should be able to... Thank you, Ingvar. Thank you. And this dam are able to perform all this. And when you construct a dam like this, you will then have a can try this, Mr. Bean. Fine, thank you. As seen here, the dam you saw was the dam in Nesjøen, upstream of Trondheim, is in Tydal. And this dam here, which was the dam on the photo, creates this reservoir. And this reservoir, the Nesjøen reservoir, is a full artificial reservoir. This Essansjøen, that was a lake, a natural lake, but this dam now rises the water level that much, so the Essansjøen and the Nesjøen, they are at the same altitude when the reservoir is full. So, and a reservoir is very useful. That's for storage of water, of course. So you can use the water when you like, by demand or by strategy. Most reservoirs in Norway, they are of course constructed for a demand because you need to store water for the winter. But now, today, in the today regime, all storage of water is by strategy. You like to earn more money later, so then you can store the water. And please keep in mind the Norwegian or Scandinavian word magasin on reservoir, because it's very normal if you go to international conference, a Norwegian or a Swede coming here, and we have very large magazines in Norway. Yes, that's a very common miss. Magasin is the Norwegian or Scandinavian word for reservoir. And I know that many of you use the word reservoir, but that's a bit... the hydropower business like to say magasin. So this dam creates a reservoir, which is very useful for power production later. There is also storage of flood water is also a secondary purpose with the power plant. All dams and reservoirs, they need spillways. A spillway must be located somewhere here, and it's very common, the normal way to construct it is to have the spillway crest here at the HRV. This is a bit more difficult if you have gates, but like here is a fixed crest spillway, and this altitude is exactly the HRV, so when the water level in the reservoir rises higher than it, water will spill. That's the procedure. And this is the spillway for Nesjø Dam. It's about 300 meter long crest. So it's quite simple and it's very reliable. This works every time you need this capacity. The intake. And this intake is more or less what you can see here. You need a water intake, which is located below even the lowest LRV here. Because if the intake was located here, you would not have been able to draw down the reservoir. So this, just to indicate here, the HRV is about here, and the LRV is, in this case, about here. So this water intake here, with the trash rack in front, with quite wide openings, is located below the LRV. And this is something you need. And it's very important that you have discharge capacity available for both the discharge, but also to distribute the pressure from the water level here. So the pressure is more or less transferred through the water column like I think that most of you have the hydraulic disc brakes on your new bicycle. I think you have. And this system is more or less the same. If this is the brake hose down to the caliper here, when you push your handle, the lever here, you transfer the hydraulic pressure through this column of liquid down to the, in your case, clipper, but here is down to the turbine. It's exactly the same. So you don't like that this intake structure should reduce the hydraulic pressure, and that's very important. Yes, inside this intake, you recognize that there is something located here, and I have made it a bit different. About here, you need some intake gates. Because if you don't have intake gates, the reservoir will end up in your power plant in all future. So you need a gate here, and this is illustrated by this gate here. You need a gate which is normally operated from a gatehouse with some lifting equipment, hydraulic or mechanical. So you need a gate here, and that's the purpose of the gate, is just to close the tunnel when you should go here for inspection, repair work, or other purposes. So this intake gate has no function through ordinary operation of the power plant. Then it's in the upper position, like here, and has no purpose. So what you can see here, normally the gates, they are located here above the tunnel system. But it's located just downstream of the intake itself. And it's not possible to operate a power plant without those gates, because you have many purposes to use it. Further downstream, we are into the tunnel. And this tunnel, this photo is from the new tunnel construct, which is still during construction. The tunnel is constructed, but the new power plant at Lysebotn is still not in operation. It's from here. So this is a photo of an unlined tunnel, which is maybe just somewhere here. And you can recognize that here is still used a kind of Scandinavian tradition to have unlined rock. And rock is the construction material for this tunnel. That's true, Krishna? That's maybe work even in Nepal? Yeah. Under special conditions. So this is a quite normal photo of a horseshoe-shaped tunnel cross-section. And most of the investments for a new hydropower plant is connected to the construction of the tunnel, from 30 to 50% of the total cost of a new power plant is in the tunnel. Yes, then we can go to the secondary intake, and that's here. Normally, we have many such secondary intakes because we have very often long tunnels, and this tunnel passes under secondary small brooks, which are taken into the power system with intakes like this. This is a quite classical Tyrolean ware intake, Tyroler intake, where water drops down through this trash rack and into the tunnel system. What is special here? That there is no... the water pressure from here is not transferred into the system at all. It's still this water level, which is the pressure in the power plant. So the pressure line is located about here, which means that water will just drop down through the intake. And that's what you can see in the photo. Water will just drop down by gravity until it reaches the pressure line here, because the water is then, water surface in the tunnel is then located here. So what you can see on my next photo is that water is just dropping down through the vertical or inclined shaft, secondary intake or brook intake shaft. It just dropped down until it reached the water level in the shaft here. And in power systems in the Alps and in Scandinavia, we have a lot of those secondary intakes. Just as a fun fact, at Ullaferre, which is the largest and most complex power scheme in Norway, we have 39 of these. At Svartisen, there are 46, which makes this system very complicated. Then, let's go to the sand trap. And sand trap is important, and it's coming up as a big issue now in hydrosand. I'm very happy to this. The sand trap is more or less an extension of the cross section in the downstream end of the tunnel. And this photo is a kind of classical, beautiful photo. It could have been presented in National Geographic, I think, by its beauty. This is the sand trap of the Tonstad power plant, unit 5, which is a huge sand trap, which is now under construction as a model in our laboratory. It's 110 meters long and a wide cross section. It's more or less, technically, it's an extension of the cross section, which reduced the water velocity in the tunnel, and all gravel and sand will drop down and be trapped here. And please remember all the time that the water velocity here is very low, and it's a pressurized flow, so it's no acceleration of water here until the cross section change. So here, the water velocity decrease a lot, and sand and gravel will be trapped here. And just to show the next photo, here is from removal of sand in the sand trap. So this is huge things. So this sand must be removed occasionally. And tilløpstunnel, that's the Norwegian word for head race tunnel. Yes, then we go further. Then we go to the surge chamber, svingekammer. And that's here, to reduce the water hammer and have a proper damping of mass oscillations, we need a surge chamber like this. And to make a photo in the surge chamber is exactly what I have tried to do. It's the complete darkness. So this is the very, very, very best of the photos I have from a surge chamber. So to illustrate that a bit better, I had to use a photo of a model, which is more or less exactly what you can see. The dimension is not similar. It's a very often it's a vertical, more or less a tank, cylindric shaped very often, and there is an upstream chamber here. And it's a downstream chamber, which is, in this case, there are two, actually. But in principle, it's normally one, like this. So when the water level is very low, you have water level here. And when the water level is high, like you can see here, what you can see here is that the water level through mass oscillation is rising, so water is flowing into this. That's exactly what you can see in this photo. So this is to, as I said, it's to reduce water hammer, and it's to have a proper damping of mass oscillations, which will occur. And it's, let's say, impossible to have a power plant without this facility.
What is water hammer?
Water hammer is trykkstøt. Yes. Which you know very well from your bathroom, I think, or similar. And it's exactly the same. The same will happen if you close down the power plant too quick. And very often you have to do so if you have an emergency situation in the unit. You have to close down.
I don't think it's obvious to me.
No, I can explain. When water is flowing like this, it has a velocity, and typical velocity in a head race tunnel is is in the range of 1 to 2 meters per second. That's maybe not a very high velocity, but it's a very high volume of water flowing here. If you have to close down the power plant, let's say in 5 seconds, due to overheating, due to some lubrication of the bearings, that's maybe the two most important situations, you have to close down and stop this unit in just very few seconds. And then you have to stop this. I will show you a photo of the valve here, where you can stop in just a few seconds. You can stop the water flow. But then you have maybe 30 kilometers of flow coming here. And I have made a small example in the Brokke power plant tunnel. You have the weight of, what was the number again? You have 35,000 full trucks, 50-ton trucks. 35,000 trucks, the weight of 35,000 trucks coming here. And you have to stop this in 5 seconds. There will be a huge increase of pressure here because all those forces have to stop here if we don't construct this. So what will happen is when we close very rapid here is that the water flow can go this way. And that's to avoid the water hammer, which is an immediate increase of water pressure, which you can recognize in your bathroom if you close the tap very rapid. Going, you maybe can hear in your basement or something. That's the trykkstøt water hammer. And that must be avoided because you will totally blow out your power plant here. So that must be avoided. The trash rack. This is the fine meshed trash rack, which is normally located here. And that's to avoid that items you don't like rock and pieces of wood and everything, not should enter your turbine. This is a protection of the turbine. And it's a quite big size. This is also from Tonstad power plant. And so there is a wide opening trash rack in the intake, but there is a fine meshed trash rack here. Then we have the pressure shaft, which is a scary area. This is also for the new Lysebotn power plant. This is going downhill. This is going from here down to the turbine. And normally, in the final end here, they are steel lined, but they are also very often unlined. But this is from the start of the steel lining. So this is steel lining covered by concrete in the rock mass. This is the head of power plants in Lyse, Bjørn Honningsvåg. I can recognize that he's smiling.
You were in there.
Yes.
No, you weren't there.
I was there. It's my photo, so yeah. I was there. Yes, this is the pressure shaft where water increases in velocity and go down to the power plant. Here, it ends up just before the upstream. This is just upstream of the turbine. This steel pipe you can see here will continue in through the power plant coming from here. And here is the closing valve, which is this one. So this photo is from here, where you can close the discharge by this. And this is a spherical valve. And you have many different kinds of valves. So you have to close, you can close the water discharge by this valve. Yes, and then we go to the turbine, and I think both the turbine and generators will be covered later, so I will not spend much time, but this is the downstream end of a Francis turbine for the Rosten power plant, which is now during construction. The turbine is connected to the generator by this shaft or axle. What do you use?
Shaft,
yes. Which is a steel shaft. And This will be distributed up to the generator. The generator will be constructed here, but I know that Arne will have a presentation later on, so I will not take any of his ideas to be presented here. But this is also the generator. And this gives all together a lot of energy, which must be distributed through some transformers here. So there is an electrical connection between the generator and the transformer here, and end up in the grid somewhere. So this is a transformer. And all this together will end up in a powerhouse. So what you see in the powerhouse by itself is almost nothing, but below the roof and the floors here, you have many interesting things. So after the water has passed the turbine, it normally goes into a draft tube, which has the cross-section of the turbine here, and end up with a much larger cross-section with a lower lower water velocity, and you gain back the loss of pressure from the high velocity here. Will gain, and you will bring back the normal pressure downstream here. That's why we use the word draft tube or sugerør. It's an under pressure here. Yes, we are close to the end. And to be able to close this, if you should go for inspections or repair work in the turbine, you have to close this turbine part, both by the valve here and by the draft tube gate, sugerørsluke, which is this one. Here you can see into the draft tube from the COPS power plant in Austria. And in the end, the water ends up here in the outlet. This is the outlet of Framruste in Øvrota. And this is entering the water level here. So now we have utilized the water pressure from here to here through this power plant. And all this is linked hydraulically through this conduit, through the turbine, and through the tail race tunnel and out. So this is more or less how a power plant works. And you should now have some ideas of this, all of you. Of course, many of you know this very well from before. But this is how it works. Thank you.